Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I have another unique infographic design in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. Okay, as I mentioned, today I'm going to teach you how to design this amazing infographic slide in PowerPoint. But in the template file, I have prepared different infographic slides for different steps, and all of them are fully animated. You can choose your favorite color between dark and light themes. Let me know which one is your favorite, dark theme or light theme. And you can download this template in the description. I'm going to explain everything step by step to make sure you won't have any problem designing this template. So let's dive in and start the tutorial. Let's start by formatting the background. Right click on it and choose Format Background. In this window, select Gradient Fill and remove these two spots. Set this color for this spot and this color for the other one. Make sure the radial type is selected and its direction is from center. Now draw a rounded rectangle. Set its height to 3.5 and width to 5.28. Let me increase its transparency to 50%. Hold the Ctrl key down and make two copies of it. Now select this shape and rotate it 60 degrees. And this one minus 60 degrees. Press Ctrl A to select all of them and align them to the middle and center. While all the shapes are selected, go to the Shape Format tab and in the Mesh Shape section, choose Fragment. Delete the center shape, then select these two and make them union. Don't worry about this line, it is a bug from PowerPoint. We can easily remove the outline. Repeat this for the other parts. If you notice precisely, there are some extra small shapes created from fragment. To delete them, press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then hold the Ctrl key down and deselect the main shapes. Now press Delete on your keyboard to delete them. I want to bring all the shapes to the center. What should I do? First, select all the shapes, then press Ctrl G to group them. And then align them to the middle and center. Now I can ungroup them. Okay, so far so good. Let's fill this shape with this color code. Go to Morph Colors window and type the code here and then decrease the transparency to 0. Let me add a drop shadow to this shape. Click on this little arrow to activate the Format Shape window. Remember, the direction of shadow is important. For this shape, I choose this direction, but for the other shapes, you should choose the proper direction. Set the blur amount to 50 and distance to 30. Let's decrease the transparency to 50%. For this shape, change the color and decrease the transparency to 0. Now set the drop shadow to this direction with the same properties. Okay, repeat this for the other shapes. But there is a problem. If you notice, we don't see the shadows properly. It is because the order of shapes is not correct. To solve this problem, activate the selection pane and rename and adjust the order of each shape according to its appearance. For example, this one is the first shape, change its name to 1 and drag it down. This one is 2 and drag it down exactly above the first shape. Repeat this respectively. Okay, now the order of all the shapes is correct, but we still have a small problem. If you look at the screen precisely, you can find out this shape doesn't have a drop shadow in this area. It is because this shape is on the top of all the layers. So you might say I can drag this layer to the top. Yes, but the problem moves to this area. Let me press Ctrl Z to undo that. To solve this problem, we should be a little creative. We have to fill this shape with a gradient fill. Right click on it and choose Format Shape, and then fill it with gradient fill. By using the eyedropper tool, choose this color for this spot and this color for the other spot. Make sure the linear type is selected and its angle is 10 degrees. Now let me drag this handle to this position. Alright, the problem is solved. Okay, let's add some icons to the slide. From the Insert tab, click on Icons and add your suitable icons to the slide. First, let's change their color. Now drag each icon to its position. Now select each shape and its icon, and by pressing Ctrl G, group them. Maybe after grouping them, the order of layers is messed up, so make sure to reorder them again. Anyway, now we have to add a text box and type the number. In this case, I'm using the objective font style. Add another text box and type your details, and then select both of them and group them. Repeat this for the other parts. Okay, let's animate them. But remember, for decent animation, you should drag each shape on a specific path like this. So duplicate the slide, then in the first slide, drag each shape to the outside on its path. By the way, you don't need to be very precise. Also, drag text boxes to the outside like this. Now add your main title and then select the second slide and add morph transition to it. Your PowerPoint is ready. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, I'll see you next.